All right. Well, thank you guys so much for sitting down with me for a second. For me, when I think about Christmas, I don't think about weddings. Have you guys in your real life experience experienced Christmas weddings? And if you have, like, what was your experience with them?
I have not experienced a Christmas wedding, but I've experienced a lot of Christmases and a lot of weddings. And I think that's what's going to make the show great,
beautiful,
right?
How
to ruin Christmas wedding, because you put them together. There's going to be a lot of organized chaos.
Right, because, I mean, Christmas is all generally about celebrations. South African weddings are a vibe. So I can tell you any wedding, whether it's happened Christmas or not, it's always been a vibe. So I look forward to seeing how we pull this one off.
Yeah, I think it's going to be great.
I'm very interested to see if people think that, like, okay, I didn't think I could do a Christmas wedding now that I've seen how it could happen, even though your character kind of just a little bit, you know, towards the beginning. Perhaps to see, like, if there can be a change in sentiment around Christmas weddings. But for you guys, like, when you read the script, when you watch this film, it looks so relatable, because we all know that one uncle, but only that one older sibling or one cousin. What was it like bringing those typical stereotypes to life in a flattering manner?
I mean, I can echo your words when you say relatable. I think that's quite a big word, and we'll use it. This is going to really, really show you who we are as a people, you know, not just segregated and separated. This is a human story. It's a people story. It's a story of love. It's a story of family. Mm. It's a story of connectedness. And it's also a story that shows how we thrive against adversities. Mm. Which is really, really in the backdrop of what we've gone through in the past couple of months. You know, families in South Africa have come out still sort of like they've survived, and they still have the connectedness together, because it's really all we relied on. And when you watch that, you almost come back to a real truth of yourself to say, even though I may have a misunderstood uncle, my uncle is my uncle and has my back all the time. Mm. My sister is my sister and has my back all the time. You know what I mean? A friend is a friend. A best friend means so much, and they become the family you choose. And so it's that. You watch this and you go, oh, there is hope. Mm. Christmas is a time to celebrate. It is a time for love. So, hell, I'd say get married in December, man.
Yeah, and just to add to that, it doesn't play into the stereotypes, but it does play into the truth of the characters. Yeah. And the characters, I think, when you watch, you'll see that all these characters are real, and these are people that people can relate to. And yeah, I think it's, the trick is not to play into the stereotype, but play the truth of what the characters really are.
Now, I think the trailer had us all shocked, because it's just very dramatic from, you know, just from like a small, small trailer. It's now all this drama. Someone is naked in the pool. Now, do you want me to trend? It was just drama. It was just very, very dramatic. Well, outside of your own character, which character were you most shocked by, and which character did you most enjoy?
Oh, most, sure, those are very difficult, because every single character can bring you to a joy, can bring you to a fear that you don't even know. But again, like you said, so relatable that it can give you to a whole, ooh, this is a solution person. So I can't necessarily pick a favorite. Mm. Really can't. But it's just how the we've balanced each other out. There's sort of two dysfunctional families from different tribes. The Tswana family, the Zulu family. You sort of see how Zulu families, when they're home, when they're together, how they fight for their love, they fight for their support. You know what I mean? So
yeah,
I couldn't necessarily pick one character. That's a very difficult question.
I mean, I think it's because of the dynamics, because every character is different. For instance, like your character around your mother, it's a very different dynamic. And then when it's with your aunts, and it's a very different dynamic there. So I think the dynamics change, and because the dynamics are changing from character to character, as they engage with one another, I think you fall more in love, not with the characters so much, but with the dynamics that exist when characters interact with each other. And How to Ruin Christmas, the wedding, I think, brings out all of that. It shows you that you cannot, you know, you don't, the same way you engage with your friend is not the same way you engage with your mother, and it's not the same way you engage with your sister. And those dynamics is what makes it interesting, and what makes the character so interesting.
And onto always, like, all on a journey of self-discovery of some sort. So this was beautiful about this three-part series, is that from episode 1 to 2, you journey with this character, and even yourself. I think your point of views about certain people and scenarios are very beautifully influenced. It gives an insight into You know what I mean? I haven't seen myself in this light, but this is me.
But I really like your dynamic between you and your sister, between Dumi and Beauty.
That's I like very yours
lovely.
With Dumi.
That's a lovely dynamic there.
Now, and like a little more seriously, you know, again, granted, while the film does not purport to like shed light on the stereotype itself, we can't deny that those stereotypes exist because there's quantifiable evidence of that, you know, microcosm of society, basically. So the question of the kind of failure sibling or failure cousin, I have always questioned, is it completely fair to jettison said family member's character over their inability perhaps to conform to what we want a family to look like? Is it that this person ain't shit? Or is it that, you know, these have different standards?
Yeah.
How did you feel playing that and navigating that role?
This is, so now here's where for me the beauty in terms of how the script in itself was structured, right? One, we must remember fictional stories. That said, the beauty of this particular title and this particular kind of comedy is, like Yonda said, the truth of characters. Misunderstood has continued to be called the black sheep until you say, but this particular misunderstood is because she stands firm in who she is. You know, she journeys into the truth of her faults, you know what I mean? Her mishaps, and it doesn't make her a bad person. What is beautiful is watching recoveries. What is beautiful is reflecting what has been misunderstood by others. And, you know, it was written in such a way that, I'll make an example, the drunk uncle. Who's to say that the drunk uncle then moves away from sort of being the patriarchal member, the supportive brother, you know what I mean? The one who'll just be the uncle who'll buy you a sweet and give you a hug when you're crying. And so I think we've pushed those boundaries to say, no. There's visions of stereotypes that have not been told our truth. We mirror a truth that we experience every single day. And that's really, really, really who a South African people are. Really misunderstood, but we just really are about love.
Yeah. And I think talking to what you asked is it really is going to make people ask the question, is really this person the bad sibling? Or are they just misunderstood? And if so, then who are they and what are they? And I think as you go through the journey, people will start to make their own decisions as to what misunderstood really is, or to what the character really is, or, you know, is there really a black sheep in the family? Or we're all just black sheep trying to figure it out? So I think for me, that is the beauty of it all, that the audience can get to decide for themselves. And these questions, you know, How to Ruin Christmas, the Wedding, will ask the audience these questions.
I appreciate your responses, but I think you touched on something very particular about, you know, what makes South African South African. And if there's one thing that, you know, in my kind of third culture kid experience, is that we wedding and we funeral very different here. Everybody gotta come. Yeah. Everybody and their mama gotta come.
Yeah.
And the cousin that nobody likes.
Yeah.
And the neighbor that is fighting with your family must actually come and see you shine.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Right.
So for you, in having experienced this pretend wedding, what part were you like, yeah, hey, perhaps we should get up, we should do away with this element of our weddings? And what was one element of the on-screen wedding that you felt like has to be continued forever and ever?
Oh, there's, how do you do away with everything that speaks of love? You know what I mean? Love, ooh, I'm going to sound very preachy here, but you know, love is kind. No, but it's true. Love is misunderstood. You know what I mean? Sometimes you fight for love, sometimes love fights for you. So I really don't think we should shy away from understanding that when families come together, sometimes things will fall apart for them to get, you know, back together again. I don't think we should shy away from being proud. I mean, I was so excited just to see the colors, our cultures, our languages. I mean, there's absolutely no regret when you meet at that. And I just may, perhaps what I would like to see more of is us really taking pride and saying, this is who we are. This is how we love. This is how we celebrate.
What's and all.
I hope that's sort of welcomed and people can get to learn us more.
For me, is Ubuntu.
No.
What you're speaking to is like the neighbor that your family is fighting with has to come. The black sheep of the family has to come. The drunk uncle has to come. All of these people have to come to witness this union, this beautiful thing that is happening. And everybody has to come together. And it's only when everyone comes together that this thing can be possible. So I think for me, that's the one element that we need to stick to. It doesn't matter if you're fighting and you've been fighting and you're not talking for years and the daughter's been gone for X amount of years, but when she comes home, she's there to make this thing happen. So Ubuntu, I think, is the one thing that we can hold on and speak to universally with everyone around the globe. I think that's something that is purely South African, but everyone can relate to.
Mm. And to close, you know, there are going to be a lot of family members, a lot of kids, a lot of couples watching this film. Now, when your characters were being introduced across the board, family to family, I'm sure you thought to yourself, self, perhaps if we had introduced each other this way, we would not have rocked each other so wrong. Do you have any advice for couples trying to introduce the one to the one's family? What would you say to them?
I'd say get to know yourself and get to know your partner so you can present a truth, because all too often, what you're saying with the stereotypes, you know what I mean? We fear that a family might not see a light that you see. You know what I mean? But if you try to
cover all the bad things that there might be there, but if you're just honest
about it, and I think it's more the you. It's presenting yourself back to your family to say, this is what love looks like to me, you know what I mean? And having that spirit of discernment to kind of go, I've chosen right because I've chosen me, and my family will ultimately be able to see that. You know what I mean? And be honest about who they are, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Imagine my partner going to his family and saying, oh, she's so quiet. Now I'm a Sid.
Yeah, and then now and you're quiet. And you know you're not quiet, but now you must sit and be quiet. Yeah, I think
the internal dialogue is gonna be like
you kind of go, no, you see, so
you just gotta be honest.
For y'all to play this role, what did you have to do to get into that excitable mood? Because it's a happy-go-lucky movie. Okay. It's just, you know, we're laughing. But it's a pandemic. As in the words of Gunn, it's a panoramic. You know, how did you guys get into getting onto set?
Look at this, you've seen the cast. Mind blowing just in themselves, our comedians in them personalities. So everybody knew that we had to uplift each other, be in a good mood, be professional, which is, again, spirit of South Africans. It's never that bad that we can't come up and say let's have a laugh. You know what I mean? We've marked Black Twitter. We know we're good. So I think it was that.
And I think props to Netflix for bringing us all together, testing us for COVID and putting us in quarantine. That way we also got to be a family, and we also got to work together much closer than we would if we were not together.
Right.
So I think the quarantine helped in a lot of ways. So yeah.
All right. See, these people think that me, I can't get all of my questions answered.
You got it. You were in there like, bah.
So you mentioned that you guys were in quarantine together, right?
Mm-hmm.
Was meeting each other in that space after like this fear that all of us have had about getting sick and about staying healthy, did that, you know, how did that play into your characters meeting across each other's families?
Right, I think it's the fear of the unknown, right? When the pandemic hit us all, we're not certain of our families, our future stability, work, and all of that. So I should imagine it's the same thing when you've had your own family and you've grown up in a certain type of way.
And now you meet somebody else. Other families, there's the uncertainty, will they like me, will they not like me, and all those things. And like I said, we got to pick up a lot of things, like our characters have been friends for a long time, and you know, the on-screen chemistry is something that develops because we spent a lot of time together. And so yeah, I mean, a lot of that worked into what happens on screen. So a lot of it, I mean, is truth. Yeah.
Well, I think this is now truly my time. And I appreciate you being so candid and open.
Thank you so very much. Thank you so much. Lovely to
thank
talk
you so
to
much.
You.
It was great.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was wonderful.
Where is my husband?
I swear this is not what it looks like.
What did it mean? Shut it down, Bob.
It's worse.
We do man love.
Can't believe my sister's getting married on Christmas Day.
Hi, Ma.
Please.
You are about to cement yourself as mommy's favorite daughter. And then marry the Black Prince Harry.
Welcome, Minister Twala, Mrs. Twala.
This wedding is of national importance and it's going to be televised. Do you know what Black Twitter is like? Do you want to make me a hashtag? I'm Ngobutokom Dala and the foot, I'm the best man.
One drink, it's not gonna hurt you.
One night of being free. Go!
Here's to giving South Africa an extravaganza that will trend for hours. Let's go for me!
What's this?
I'm going to kill you!
Oh, fuck. It's Christmas. This is the time where we get together.
My husband is cheating on me.
We wash down the past with great wine.
Oh, Lumes! Lumes, Bumay, legend!
Hey! You marry out of your circle with Dali Linki. Hang about a sound or a sigh from your wife. I'll take her out.
A lot of people have tried over the years.
I accept the challenge.
Thank you.
I'd like to say something just before the wine gets to my head.